This is the spinal cord, also known as spinal medulla. The spinal cord lies in the vertebral canal and it is about 45 centimeters in length or 18 inches in length. It is a continuation of the medulla oblongata and extends from the level of foramen magnum, which corresponds to upper border of the atlas vertebra, up to the lower border of the first lumbar vertebra. So the lower end of the spinal cord, it is at the level of lower border of L1 vertebra in adults. Now here we can see the dura mater, which has been opened up, and the spinal cord can be seen, which is ending here in the lower part. This lower tapering part of spinal cord, this lower tapering part of spinal cord is known as conus medullaris. So this is the conus medullaris, and this fibrous filamentous sheath, which is attached to the apex of the conus medullaris, from here, which is a continuation of the pia mater, this is known as phylum terminale. So this is the phylum terminale, this is the apex of conus medullaris, this is the lower tapering end of spinal cord, and this continuation of pia mater, which is surrounded by the subarachnoid space within the dural sac, this is the phylum terminale internum, or the internal part of phylum terminale. After second sacral vertebra, the pia mater continues surrounded by the dural sheath up to the posterior surface of the coccyx vertebra. So that part is known as phylum terminale externum. So there are two parts of phylum terminale. One is phylum terminale internum, from the level of lower border of L1 up to S2 vertebra, where subarachnoid space ends. From S2 vertebra up to the coccyx vertebra, there is just pia mater surrounded by dural sheath, but no subarachnoid space. So that is known as phylum terminale externum. So this is one of the modification of the pia mater, that is phylum terminale. Surrounding phylum terminale, we can see this bunch of spinal nerve roots occupying the lower part of the vertebral canal. This bunch of spinal nerve roots, it resembles like tail of a horse, and it is known as cauda equina. The cauda equina is because of the oblique downward course of the lower lumbar, sacral and coccygeal nerve roots, which have to come out from their respective intervertebral foramina, so that in the lower part of the vertebral canal we can see bunch of these lower lumbar, sacral and coccygeal nerve roots, which resemble like a tail of a horse, and that is known as cauda equina. So in the lower part, lower end of the spinal cord, we can see three important features. One is the conus medullaris, this is the phylum terminale, and surrounding there are bunch of spinal nerve roots, which is cauda equina. Now there is another modification of the pia mater, which we can see on each side of the spinal cord. These structures, this thickening of the pia mater on each side, this is known as ligamentum denticulatum. There are such 21 pairs of triangular tooth-like processes, and these are present between the ventral nerve root and the dorsal nerve roots. As we can see here, these are the ventral nerve roots. These are the ventral nerve roots, and behind are the dorsal nerve roots. Between them we can see this thickening of pia mater on each side. This is the ligamentum denticulatum. These ligamenta denticulata, such 21 pairs, this help suspend the spinal cord in the midline and prevent injury to the spinal cord during excessive movements of the neck or during jumping. The third modification of the pyameter we can see is the thickening of the pyameter along the anterior median fissure. This white glistening band which is present in the anterior median fissure, this is known as linea splendens. So this is the linea splendens. The pyameter which goes into the anterior median fissure can be seen as a glistening white band throughout the anterior median fissure. This is known as a linea splendens, which is the third modification of the pyameter. Along with the linea splendens, we can see a bluish blood vessel running in the anterior median fissure. So this blood vessel is the anterior spinal artery. So in this fissure, anterior median fissure, we can see two structures. One is the white glistening band, that is a linea splendens, and running along with it, there is an anterior spinal artery. So this is the anterior surface of the spinal cord. Posteriorly, we can see on the posterior surface of the spinal cord, this is the posterior median sulcus, and this is the posterolateral sulcus, where we can see the rootlets of the posterior nerve root attached on each side. Between the posterior median sulcus and posterolateral sulcus, we can see two tracts, thin longitudinal tracts. The medial one is fasciculus gracilis and the lateral one will be fasciculus guineatus. Also, on each side along the posterolateral sulcus, we can see the posterior spinal artery. So this is the location of the posterior spinal artery, one on each side along the posterolateral sulcus. So this is the posterior surface. When we take a transverse section of the spinal cord, we can clearly see the inner H-shaped gray matter. So this is the H-shaped gray matter, in which the broader part, this part, will be the ventral horn, and the slender part will be the dorsal horn. So this is anterior and this is the posterior surface. So H-shaped, which is actually looking whitish in color, this is the H-shaped or butterfly-shaped gray matter, and surrounding it is the white matter of the spinal cord. So these are the important features of the spinal cord.